Hi friends, I am Devika.N.S, studying in Plus 2 Humanities, GHSS Vettathur of Pindalmanna Taluk, Malappuram District, Kerala State. Now, I try to present the expected questions with their answers in brief from the first chapter of Second Year Sociology entitled Introducing Indian Society. Question number 1. Prior knowledge about society is both an advantage and disadvantage for learning sociology. Explain the statement. Answer: advantage. Students feel that sociology is an easy subject to learn as they already know a few things about sociology. Disadvantage. Prior knowledge about society creates problems because many of the things already learned have to be unlearned or corrected. So, the study of sociology begins with this initial process of unlearning. Unlearning is difficult. Question number 2. Previous knowledge regarding society is partial. This has two meanings. What are they? Answer: A. Incomplete and B. Biased. Question number 3. The point of view regarding society is different for each person. So, it should be viewed in a different angle. What is the technical term for it? Answer: self-reflexivity. Question number 4. What are the differences between geographical map, social map, and common sense map? Answer: geographical map. A geographical map locates your place and nature of your land. Example: suppose you live in the state of Arunachal Pradesh. You know that your state is in the northeastern corner of India. Your state is small compared to many large states such as Uttar Pradesh and larger than Goa. Social map. A social map determines your position in relation to others in society. Your age, language, caste, religion, race, etc. are the important factors of social map. For example, you are an adolescent who believes in Hinduism, belongs to Nayar caste, speaks Malayalam language, hails from a middle class family. Common sense map. A common sense map is one version of map already provided to us in childhood on the basis of common sense knowledge. This kind of map can be misleading and distorted. They are not scientific. Social maps are scientific. Question number 5. Identify the term used to study the relationship between personal problems and public issues. Who proposed this term? Explain with an example. Answer: the term used to study the relationship between personal problems and public issues is sociological imagination. C.W. Mills proposed this term. Example: you may be unhappy with the treatment of elders, brothers, sisters, or friends in your family. It is not a personal problem. It is a public problem. This is called generation gap. This generation gap between older and younger generations is a social problem. In the same way, unemployment, issues of communalism or casteism, gender inequalities are all public issues.